Christmas saints, Merry Christmas sinners, for that is what we all are, created in the image of God, but still very much in need of God's grace and God's forgiveness. Well, Merry Christmas. It is a blessing to have you as we worship God with one another. This is a very special service that we have. Traditionally, it's called a service of lessons and carols. We will gather together, sing some songs, hear scripture read, and at the end, we will sing a holy night with candles. It is a beautiful service to be had here. We are very excited to have you. We also want to let you know that we will collect a special offering this evening. We know that on Christmas Eve, we have more guests than normal, and so we want to let you know that we will take an offering midway through worship, and that 100% of this offering will go out the doors in mission. None of the offering that we collect tonight will go to pay the light bills or electricity or anything like that. That 100% of this offering will actually go to serve those who are out in the world, to help clothe the naked, to feed the hungry, actually save the lives of people around the world. We hope that you will consider giving to this very worthy cause. as we celebrate the birth of Christ together. I hope you will pull out a white welcome card out of your bulletin. Please fill this out with as much information as you feel comfortable, especially if you're a guest with us this evening. We would love to know that you're here and love to learn anything about you that you're willing to share. You'll have some time midway through worship to fill this out, and we can place this in the offering plate whenever that time comes in worship. On the back, we have an invitation to exploration. If you are a guest with us and are interested in learning more about what church membership means here at Acts 2, we would invite you to this event on January 22nd at 12:15 out in the chapel. Hope you will consider that as well. We are excited that you are here. I hope that you will join me in a word of prayer. God, we thank you so much for this time and this day that we have to sing your praises. God, we pray that you would pour down your Holy Spirit upon us now, and that in this time as we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, God, that we would truly consider your word made flesh, that we would invite you into our lives this time, that we would leave this place as light shines in the darkness. We pray for this in the power of the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Well, for the last several weeks, we have been lighting a different candle to commemorate the season of Advent, season of preparation as we prepare our hearts and our minds for the birth of Christ. We've remembered love, joy, peace, and hope these last 4 weeks, and tonight we light the Christ candle to represent the fact that Christ has now come into our lives, that God's word has actually entered this world. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Now let's all stand as we sing out together and sing praises to our Lord this night. may be seated as we hear from the Word of God.
Hear these words from Genesis chapter 22. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let's have the kids come on up.
All right. How are you guys?
Come on up. Everybody's out of school. Hey, hey. What a deal. We're excited to see you all tonight. We hope you have a very Merry Christmas and safe travels as you go to grandmas and grandpas and aunts and uncles and friends and neighbors. We are so glad to see you tonight. And Miss Joetta has a lot to teach us.
All right. What is this big thing here beside me?
Candy.
A candy cane, that's right. When we go over to children's tonight, we're going to hear a story about the candy cane. Now, when it's turned this way, do you know what it kind of looks like? A shepherd's staff. Remember, the shepherds were the first one to hear about the birth of Jesus? And if we turn it this way, it's a Jay, and Jay stands for Jesus. And we remember Jesus' birth by that. So we need to thank God for giving us Jesus and so that we can have salvation. Pastor Andy, would you pray for us?
I'd love to. Let's pray. God, I thank you for your salvation. I thank you that you came to save us. God, I pray for these, your children here, that you would bless all of them, that your spirit would pour out upon us in this time, that we would become aware of you, your love, and your mercy this day. We pray it in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. All right, you guys can go with Miss Joetta and our awesome volunteers, and we'll see you back in about 20 minutes.
Now would you please stand as we read from the scripture once again.
Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Glory to the newborn King, peace on
But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then he rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they shall live secure. For now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
You may be seated.
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? And Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save us sons and daughters? Did you know?
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him to the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. This is the word of the Lord.
Now let's all stand again as we sing this out together. We sing to our Lord and our Father. Let's sing "Angels We Have Heard."
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly sing it, Lord. And the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strain. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Christmas, everyone. Let's share in the Christmas story together. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. You may be seated. Over the last month, something our tradition calls Advent, we've been looking at the wonder of Christmas. The wonder of Christmas. This Christmas at Acts 2, we've been wondering about lots of things. But one of the things I found out early on is that you can't wander in a hurry. Can you say that with me? You can't wander in a hurry. You just can't do it. You can't wander in a hurry. So my prayer for us in the next few days is that we will slow down and wonder at the gifts all around us. I hope you'll slow down and appreciate that the God of the universe, that the God that could do anything, chose to come to earth through a slow 9-month gestation process in the form of a baby boy named Jesus. And I wonder what it would be like if we took on the lifestyle of Jesus and never hurried again. Really, think about that. If you never hurried again. Now, sure, we can move quickly from time to time, but never again that anxious, fear-induced, pit-in-your-stomach kind of hurry that puts us on the very edge of raising our voices to our children and our spouses and our coworkers and other drivers on the road. What would our lives look like if we promised that in the next 3 days we would practice growing slowly, ever so slowly, and becoming more and more like our loving Lord Jesus? Jesus, the one who walked everywhere he went, and yet somehow saved the world at that very slow pace. I know I'm preaching uphill now to a lot of folks. But when we slow down, we become entranced by the wonder of a star. When we look up at the sky tonight before you go to bed and look at the stars that God has made, this is what wise men do. We can begin to see things that God wants us to see. A star, a bird, a flower, a friend, a person in need. Once you believe in Christmas, even barns and animals and feeding troughs can become places of miracles. Matthew 2:11 says this, "On coming to the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh." I want you to just imagine in your mind's eye with me for a second how odd that must have been. Grown men from other countries laying down before the Lord. These are men with considerable wealth, prestige, and power, kneeling or completely prostrating themselves before a little baby or a little boy, Jesus. Now, I've noticed that it is very difficult to kneel in a hurry. I've seen some of you try to do it at communion, but it's really tough. Can't really kneel in a hurry either. You see, the wise men stopped where the star was and they worshiped Jesus. I hope you will stop this week and think about the wonder of a name as well. Wonder with me about the name above all names, Jesus, Yeshua, the form of Joshua, which means God saves or God is salvation. What must this sort of name have meant for people ruled by a foreign government? And if they rushed to judgment, they would surely think that Caesar's days were numbered since the Messiah Jesus had arrived. Certainly, this is what Herod was afraid of. But Jesus didn't rush anywhere. He came in the fullness of time and brought light to the darkness, grace, and truth. Hope where there had been despair. And as we wonder at the name of Jesus, we are reminded that this is the time and this is the name that every knee and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, Master, Savior, Jesus. Wonder with me tonight. What does the name Jesus mean to you personally tonight? Who is Jesus to you tonight? Is it a name of hope for you? Is Jesus master and friend? Or is Jesus just a good idea? Fire insurance of sorts, the sort of thing you hope you have in the back of a drawer somewhere, but you hope you never have to use it. I can tell you for sure that the relationship Jesus has in mind for you does not work like that. Jesus will be Lord or nothing at all. No negotiating the name above all names. He is loving kindness, everlasting steadfastness. And we can accept the name of Jesus as Lord, but then, of course, as we do, he is our forever master. He's a good master. And where he goes, we follow. So slow down with me for just a moment and consider the wonder of a promise. The promise is that Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us. Whenever dark days come, and of course they come to all of us, even at Christmas, rather than saying, "God, get me out of this," we can claim the promise, "God, get into this with me. You are Emmanuel, God with us. Get into this with me. I'm looking for you. I'm searching for you. Let me search for you and find you and walk with you all the days of my life. Be Emmanuel to me again tonight. I love the story about a dad and his little girl. They were walking side by side, and the dad said, "Honey, hold my hand." And she said, "No, Daddy, no." And he was curious, so he asked her to go on, and she said, "If I hold your hand, I might get tired, or I might not be strong enough to hold on, Daddy. You hold my hand, because you are strong. You are strong enough to never let me go." Now, this is our prayer. This is our promise that Jesus, as proven at Easter, is strong enough even over death, to hold on to us and raise us up to new life. Our promises in the resurrection, as well as at the manger. Ask Jesus to fulfill the promise that he came not to save the righteous, but sinners, people like you and me who need help, real help tonight. And hold on to the promise that Jesus has a hold of you. He's got you. You don't have to worry about getting him. He's got you. Ask him to hold on to you tonight. And finally, we come to the wonder of a manger. The wonder of a manger, God's sneak attack. While the world did and still does look for power and prestige and glamour and violence and showy display, God chooses to come slowly, lowly, in humility, in peace, and under the radar. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph came to a world that had no room for them. They did not fit the rich and famous profile. They were not the top power couple to watch in Bethlehem. They did not make the hot 30 under 30 or any other list that mattered. Except, of course, they made the tax roll for Rome, which led them to Bethlehem in the first place. And we stop and we wonder, why a manger? How could God allow such a thing? And if we stop and wonder, we find that the manger is the perfect place for God to show up if you want to be found and accepted by shepherds. Where else could you go and be found by them? Where else would show the incredible lengths that a completely holy, powerful, almighty, all-knowing God would go to reach you and me tonight? So that no matter how low you go, no matter where you try to hide, no matter how bad you think your life has become, the God of the universe says, "Hey, I'll meet you there. I'll meet you there. Wherever there is for you, I'll go to it. I'll go and meet you. And when we meet, everything will be all right." Wherever God meets us, miracles happen. In hospital rooms, soccer fields, halfway around the world. This is the wonder of the manger. So last year, I wandered to Turkey and Syrian refugee camps. I met this little one. She had a sign that said, "Please, me and my family need help. A wife and three girls, we are from Syria. We are here because we have no place to be safe. Thank you. May God help you help us." I took out a little zone bar from my backpack and I gave it to her. And that's all I could do. It got her down the road another day. And you know what I found out all the way across the world in Turkey? God was there. Will you say that with me? God was there. And last week, I wandered to La Tortuga, Guatemala. And guess what? You know what to say? God was there. I met a 9-year-old girl named Melanie. And she went to the river with her mom and her sister and her brother and her aunt. And she began to wash clothes. And then she began to drink the water with no idea that it could kill her. Because of cholera,
this is my friend
parasites.
We spent the week together playing and putting in this well. I'm going to give him some water now. It's nice and clean and ready to drink. Go ahead.
So this is a little Edris, also in the village. And your church put in that well in 4 days. And now that village has clean water for the rest of its history. Just like that. Changing lives, changing the world. And as you do it, it's not a drag to be where Jesus is. It's a blast. It's a ball. We had a good time. Some of you were there. We had a good time. Water everywhere. The kids are happy. They can be healthy and they have new life. Because what Jesus Christ is doing in your life, that's the way it is with Jesus. It spreads joy to the world. And we've been to places like Rio Bravo, Mexico, El Salvador, Haiti, Uganda, Germany, England, Nigeria. And guess what? Say it with me. God was there. At Emerson High School, down in Oklahoma City, Regional Food Bank, Hope Center of Edmond, the tiny faces of the children being fed by the YMCA all across Oklahoma City. And guess what? God was there. And when we said goodbye to loved ones this year, very difficult, especially this time of year, guess what? God was there. And when we welcome newborn babies all over the place in this church, guess what? God was there. And when we worship together, God was there. And when we ate together, God was there. And when we studied on Wednesday nights in small groups, God was there. And when the children played at Vacation Bible School, was God there? Yes, God was there. And when the junior high kids went to Journey Camp, God was there. And when the senior high kids went to Day Spring, God was there. And when we opened our facilities to babies and toddlers and families of Children's Day Out, God was there. Wherever you go, whatever you do, there's nothing so secular that God can't show up, meet you right there, and make it sacred, special, holy, set apart. Even in an ordinary name, in a nowhere town, with a promise made long ago to a people who had given up hope, to show up in an outbuilding with some sheep. Even there, even here, God was there. Emmanuel, God with us. Amen. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you that there is no place that we can go that you are not there already. We pray with the ancients that you are the God that goes before us, behind us, beneath us, and above us. We thank you that you are there. And that because of Christmas, there is no place that we can go that you have not gone before us by the power of your Holy Spirit, by the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ. It's in his wonderful name that we have learned how to pray by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. In just a moment, we're going to take up a very special offering that we do twice a year. We'll do it here at Christmas Eve, and then we'll also do it at Easter. These two offerings make up the entirety of our mission budget for the whole year. And so we want you to know that you are changing lives, literally saving tens of thousands of lives every year as you give to this offering. You can also give online if you'd prefer. Now, we put up two photos here to remind you that we still are doing good work for the Syrian refugees, providing them heat and food and clothing and shelter. And to the right is a little girl named Milagros, which means miracle. She's a walking miracle thanks to the work of the church and Living Water, put in our 14th water well there. We also have a partnership with the Migrant Offshore Aid Station where they've saved more than 11,000 lives by simply pulling people out of the Aegean Sea and the Mediterranean Sea where people have been taking advantage of them and people have been drowning. And so we are a part of saving people's lives. And I would remind you what Jesus says, as you've done it to one of the least of these, you've done it to me. And so this is our chance to make a difference. Around here we say it's Jesus' birthday, and so let's honor him on his birthday by giving generously to the things that he cares about. We invite you now to give with glad and generous hearts.
Jesus laid down his dream.
Amen. Let us pray. God, we thank you so much for these gifts and offerings given in your name. God, we pray that you would bless them, that you would pour out your Holy Spirit upon this offering and upon the hands that receive them. God, that these would truly give us the power to change the world, to bring your kingdom upon this earth. For we pray it all in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Well, each and every time we gather for worship, most of all, we remember Christ. We remember not only his birth, but him giving his very life for us, his death, and ultimately resurrection, that he would save all of us. And we give thanks. We remember that on the night that Jesus was betrayed, that the next morning he would be crucified for our sins, that he chose to spend that night, the last night of his life, with his disciples. And he sat down at a meal with them, and he took bread, and he gave thanks to God, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples. He said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, the meal was over, Jesus took the cup, and he gave thanks to God, and he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take, drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of a new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so it's in remembrance of these mighty acts in Jesus Christ that we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and a living sacrifice. Will you pray with me? Heavenly Father, pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we might be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes back in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, through your Holy Spirit and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. I invite the communion stewards to come forward at this time to help prepare the gifts of God for the people of God. It'll work best if we have six on either side. In a moment, you'll be invited to come forward and participate in the sacrament of Holy Communion. And we want you to know that you don't need to be a member of this church or any church to receive communion here, that this is a gift offered to all people. We practice what's called open communion, which means that anybody can participate in communion, even adults on down to children. You'll be invited to come forward and kneel at the kneeling rails for a time of prayer. When you're ready to receive the elements, you can look up and place your hands in the form of a cross. You'll be given a piece of bread, and you'll be told, "This is the body of Christ." After that, you'll be given the cup. We use grape juice. And you can dip the bread into the juice and be told, "This is the blood of Christ." And you can take the elements together. If you have little ones with you, they might be told, remember that Jesus loves you, for that's what we remember at this meal. This is a chance that we have to invite Christ into our life, that his power, his glory might reign within us. And maybe that's the first time that you've ever done that. We want to celebrate that along with you. We hope that you would take advantage of this time to come and receive Christ. Will you receive him this day? We hope and pray that you will.
New and glorious form. Oh, His law is love, and His gospel is peace. Chains shall He break, for the slave is our brother, and in His name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise His holy.
Just a moment, we'll come to the most beautiful part of the service. We're going to read the good news according to the Gospel of John and remind us that God is light and in Him is no darkness at all. And then we're going to share the light with one another as we sing Silent Night, Holy Night. And so we invite you to hold your candle. And then when the lit candle comes, tip the unlit candle and it will save your bangs and your hands from wax. It'll be awesome. And pass it to the people next to you. And on the last verse, you'll see a little asterisk come up. And we'll follow out. Andy and I will lead as we take the light out into the world. Any questions? All right, let's stand. And share God's good word together. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him, and without Him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in Him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through Him. He Himself was not the light, but He came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through Him. Yet the world did not know Him. He came to what was His own, and His own people did not accept Him. But to all who received Him, who believed in His name, He gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Merry Christmas, friends.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. So tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on, and forever. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born.